comparisons. What is going on, guys? Spooky Guy 444 here, back at you with a new style of videos. If you might have noticed from this weird little intro thing that I just did, kind of a play out of my prop review. This is going to be comparisons. Now with these comparison videos, I'm basically just going to do two items of very similar nature and do comparisons on them. It's not creative, you know, it's been done before by many, many haunters, and I really want to do it because my collection has been getting bigger and bigger over the years, duh. And you know, I've gotten to the point where I have props that are very similar in nature. Not all my props are very, very different from each other now. I have another one planned down the road. Not sure when it'll come out, but it will in the future. Maybe October, like mid-October, something like that. I have another one planned as soon as I can get it to my house. But you guys will see it then. But in today's comparison, we are going to be doing a comparison on the Target 2020 Crispy Corpse Tombstone and the Target 2020 Ticket Booth Tombstone. I know that's not the official name of it, I'm not really sure what it is, but yeah, I got both of these guys. I got the Crispy Corpse last year and I got the Ticket Booth one probably a week ago. So yeah, without further ado, let's get into today's comparison. And here we are. Here are the Target 2020 and 2021 tombstones, there being the new for 2021 Ticket, Fright This Way, I think it might be the actual name, and the 2020 Crispy Corpse. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to do the cons and the pros first, and then I'll do the things that are similar, things that are different, and we're obviously going to do demos, and then I'll give my initial thoughts. So without further ado, let's get into today's video. So I guess to start off with the cons of the Ticket Booth, I do actually have a few. And that is the lighting. I'm not a huge fan of the green. I really don't think it looks well with that orange dot. I think the orange dot is fine, but in my opinion, the lights actually should have gone across this, like these orange dots that are across the tombstone. I think that would have been a lot cooler than the green that's kind of just shined on throughout different areas. But I do, however, like the one that's actually inside the pumpkin head itself. I do think that is cool. But I just don't like the green light placement. I don't think it should have been green. I think they should have gone with orange, because it's clear that I think that orange would have been something. Or what they should have done is just made these dots green. I don't know. I just find the orange to be quite odd with the green lighting. But yeah, another one of my cons is the audio itself. The actual, like, pumpkin talking is okay. It's the weird, like, booing noises that are at the end of every audio track, and I'm just not a huge fan of them. I think they're just very out of place and odd. It's like, oh, but you don't want to be in the cemetery, just fuck you. But yeah, it's weird. I'm not a huge fan of the audio's final leg of the phrases, but it's not like something that ruins the entire animatronic for me like it would say on a Johnny Punk or a man-eating plant. But yeah, that's really my only two main cons with this one. Let's get on to Crispy Corpse. So with Crispy Corpse, I really don't honestly have that many cons. I think he's really cool. I like his design. The lighting looks great. Maybe this is a con I have with both, is the cheesy audio. But what do you expect? It's Target. I'm not expecting, you know, like, him audio on, like, these things, you know? So I'm not, like, complaining. Like, it's what I expect from a Target lineup. But yeah, I really don't have any cons with Crispy Corpse. I really don't. Maybe one that could be a con is that they're very similar in nature, like, design-wise. Like, the skull is at the top of both, and they have the little curls in the certain areas, and I don't know, I think they could have done something more unique than just, you know, kind of like rehashing the same, like, kind of vacuum form mold. I'm not sure, though. But yeah, honestly, do really like both of these guys still. So now, let's get on to the pros. So, first, I really like how unique the motion is on the Fright This Way. I really, really like the moving arm. He's like a greeter. He's like, you know, enticing you to come up to him. And I think that's really cool. However, it does look kind of odd, and this isn't really a con because you're not going to notice it from far away. The arm kind of sticks out a little bit, but it's not a huge issue. But, you know, I think he is still really, really cool. I really like the arm motion. It's actually a very, like, neat looking hand. Like, they actually did a pretty good job molding it. It looks super cartoony. And it looks great. I think it fits right in. And then my other definitely pro, I would say, is for sure the light inside of the head itself. I think looks very, very cool. And the green lights do look cool. It's just I'm not a big fan of the placement. And I wish it would have been green throughout or orange throughout. Now for the pros with Crispy Corpse, I do have a few, and that would definitely be the design. I really like his general design. I just think he looks great, medieval. Always really cool. I see a lot of people on Instagram, haunted community wise, just, I don't know, they're not huge fans of medieval themed items. However, I do really, really like him. And I really do like medieval props. I wouldn't mind doing a medieval haunt, you know, sometime in the future. Then my other pro is definitely the lighting placement. I like how there's two lights like right in front of the head and the eyes of course light up. I think they look great, and I think a pro that I can say for both of them is their constant mode, which is nice. Really, really nice to have them all constant. What would be really cool for him, and I don't think he has it, but like a constant mode, but it's almost like waving Wally towards like actually constant, and it only like goes off whenever you walk up to him, which I think would be really, really cool. Because, you know, it just have him lighting up and the hand moving, but he wouldn't talk until you'd actually, like, kick off the sensor. I know there's some Costco items that do that as well. Very, very cool. But, yeah, those are really my main pros with both of these guys. So, let's get into demos. So, first I'm going to demo all of the phrases on the Fright This Way. I will do two... I'm not actually sure how many phrases he has. I'll do a few of them in the light here, and then I'll turn the light off. It won't make much of a difference, but yeah. And I'll get some close-up shots, of course.
Come all, and hopefully, you're not here to stay permanently. It's a spooky night, and I'd like to say, please grab your treats and be on your way. What a spooky costume! What a frightful mask! Get your treats and have some is all that I would ask. Happy Halloween to all who pass. I would love to join you, but I'm stuck here, alas. That is the spookiest costume that I've ever seen. So have a very happy Halloween.
Now let's get into Crispy Corpse demo. And yeah, you know, overall, I would say I do like his audio a bit more, even though it's still equally as, like, cheesy. But yeah, he's still very cool. So let's get into Crispy Corpse's activation.
I recall the time I battled a wretched undead corpse in Egypt. He was no match for me, and I sent him running home to his mummy. One might say it is a good night to share your candy with a good night. Old traveler, none shall pass here. But I could let you slip by if you give me some candy. I would gladly join you on your adventure, but after a few blocks, my feet are really dragging. I have seen many monstrous creatures on my adventures, but none quite as terrifying as you. Oh, wait, it's just a costume.
Alright, and then if you guys just want to give me 1 second, I'm going to have these guys going off on constant simultaneously. It's going to hurt my ears, but I'm doing it for you guys, so... give me 1 second. Hope you guys enjoy.
It's a spooky night, and I'd like to say, please grab your treats and be on your way. None quite as terrifying as you. Oh, wait. What a spooky costume. What a frightful man. You should remember to brush your teeth after you eat your candy. It's all that I would ask. Otherwise, you'll be getting a real bad case of dragon breath. Happy Halloween to all who passed. I would love to join you, but I'm stuck here, alas. He was no match for me, and I sent him running home to his mummy. That is the spookiest costume that I've ever seen. What I say, it is a good night to share your candy with a good night. Old traveler, none shall pass here.
I see, but I can let you slip by if you give me some candy.
I would gladly join you on your adventure.
Overall, In my personal opinion, I'm going to say that the better one of these two is definitely Crispy Corpse. He's, in my opinion, just has the better detail, better audio, better lighting. However, I still do really, really like the ticket booth. But overall, I really hope you guys did enjoy today's video. Leave a like and comment. Tell me who you think is better, Ticket Booth or Crispy Corpse. Let me know down below. I'm SpookyGuy444, and I will see you all next time. Goodbye.